morning, officer. Are we not allowed to sleep here? I thought we could. I'm so sorry.
No, that's fine. I'm here about your friend here.
It's my brother.
We had a report that your brother might be in some danger. Somebody might be looking for him, that Omar Navarro is looking for him in order to kill him. Is there any truth to that?
No. Goodness, no. My brother's sick. He's mentally ill, and we just got out of the hospital, and we were just listening to a story about Omar Navarro on NPR, so this is all, it's just a huge misunderstanding.
I'm gonna have to ask you both to step out of the vehicle, please, ma'am.
Officer, can we not make this more complicated?
Step out of the car, please. I'm gonna ask you a few questions, then we're gonna take a look inside the car.
All right. We can step outside the vehicle, but you know, search and seizure laws now say we're not required to answer any of your questions. And if you want to search this vehicle, you're gonna have to get a warrant. And that would be such a waste of time and resources, and on a weekend, no less, all because of you. And you know, I'd be really curious as to what you would cite as cause on this warrant. What, some absolute nonsense? My brother, who just got off a psychiatric hold, by the way, just rattled off to some drifter in a parking lot? So, can't we just let this go, please? And you can focus your good intentions elsewhere.
You a lawyer?
No.
Well, we have your license plate information, so you two just be extra careful.
Thank you, officer. God damn it. What are you trying to do to me? What would you do? What would you do if you were me? You're like a fucking toddler. You make me want to drink at 7 in the morning. You make me want to drink.
I'm sorry.
No talking. No more talking for the rest of the trip.
Where are we going?
Oh, for God's sake. Jesus H. Christ.